Well, here we are, back at Riverside again. I'm like 100 yards from the Dundee bridge. Past few trips have been awful. Is it locative? Blanked. Tried the leaving beach in Fife and blanked over there as well. Had a shot at Brody Ferry yesterday, two flounders. Had a shot at Discovery Point last week, one wee flounder, one wee smelt. So, four trips, but not a lot of fish. So, here's hoping something better comes along this time. It's a bit misty, the water's got a bit of movement in it, and it's also dirty brown. Better today, mackerel, nice little mackerel, blue, and we've also got lugworm. On the hope that if I catch nothing with a fish bait, I'll get something with the worms. Well, that's the idea. The truth is always something different, but we'll try it anyway. And as you can hear, we're actually on the roadside. All kinds of traffic, so I hope you can hear me a little bit. So, there's a bit of a wind coming from the back there. Hopefully that will not interfere with us. But it's chilly. It's summer's day. Wish it was over on the west coast. They're getting some high temperatures over there, but I'm on the east, so we'll suffer with the mist and the cold. So let's get down to the fishing. Well, that's us baited up. As I say, yesterday I was down at Brody, caught a couple of flounders. They were decent size, like, but due to dogs and dog walkers, disobedient dogs, it was no fun. A bait pinched, even managed to hook a dog in the mouth and got it free. So, shouldn't have those problems up here. Maybe they were cyclists. I've got to admit, the scenery was lovely around here. Okay, so here we are. This is where we're fishing from, and this is what we're fishing into. The River Tay, with the Newport over there. And up near the bridge, Wormite.
I was over at Wormit earlier, but got a fish off the beach. There's just too much mud. Tide's too far out. That can be a problem when you're fishing further up here. Further up from here, there's an area people like to park. Sandy's got a cafe. But a certain high tide, you can't fish because there's no water. It's all sand for about 200-300 yards minimum. So there we go. Rail bridge. And as you can see, it's only about 10 feet from the road. So when you're casting, just to be careful. Pendulum might be a bit much on here, but that's what I use anyway. It works. Never hit anybody yet. That's a view down the river, our view down Riverside. Getting new flats on the left hand side down there. There's meant to be quite a few of them going up. So, there we go. And the view along the wall. Don't find yourself in that mud. You can go up to your knees in it in some areas. So, handy thing to have around here would be a landing net. Especially when the tide comes in a bit, because sometimes you get caught up in all that weeding. More often than not, lose a fish. Especially if they're darting back and forward. Which happens on occasions. So, this is us. Big fish. Fishing all around. And my lovely flask. Just fell into a pile of bits. My coffee's going to go cold today, because that's that knackered. £5 down the drain. Time for a new flask, I think. Well, that's us. Get back to the fishing now, and get back to my coffee. Our first little flounder. There was two on, but that's now back swimming in the tape. So this is that. First cast, first flounder. Nice going. The rod. There's another flounder. Smaller one this time, but still a flounder. And as you can see, you're getting bothered with little gripping weed. This stuff is really annoying, it just grasps round your line like that. Especially when it gets on your leader knot, you try to wind them fish. That's a chance, that's when you have a big chance of losing the fish. This is a view of the other side of the bridge. As you can see, the tide does go a fair bit out here. If you go further up there, quite a nice sandbank. Especially up by the car park, you need to be a good caster, and there's not a lot of water up there. And big sandbanks out there as well. On the bigger, on the really low tides, there's a lot of sand that goes out beyond that bank out there. If I remember right, we used to play football out there on the sandbanks. Don't know this one. But as I say, pretty good casting needed to get in there, and you might find fish in that pool, but very few. This is under the bridge itself, still muddy. Rocky. And as usual, they're working on it. So, yeah, that wee building up there, that's a cafe. It's an end, you can go inside, sit and eat a meal, or they've got a little train. A lot of pieces of the train which is used for carryouts. Nice. And the food's pretty cheap too. I'm not, I don't get paid for advertising this. Worse luck. That's the tide on the turn, it's now coming in. Done not bad, we've had four fish, dropped one. So, it's a good start. Best of it for a few, couple of weeks anyway, so let's hope it continues. I think we'll get more before the day's out. So, let's go back to the fishing. Thank you. flounder. They get smaller. Here we go, another flounder. A better light size this time. A few more like that, or maybe bigger would help. Yeah. Oh! I've noticed this in the bottom. Talk about getting small. I mean, fuck! Man, the bait's nearly bigger than that is. So that's two of them at once. Pain in the butt, but after all that, we still have our flounder. But the weed's clogging up, the gear's just getting dragged up the river. But we'll stick to it. Inevitable weed, but there you go. I just lost the last trace, it got caught up in a load of weed. No, can't win everything. That's a nice wee fish. So, we'll get that back. We'll get back to this. Right, that's... hope you can hear me over this traffic. That's just after low tide, so... I've had 10 flounders, 10 that we've caught, and I've lost a couple on the way up due to weed, etc. But it's been not bad so far. Still the rest of the tide to go, and still getting knocks here and there. Still plenty of weed right enough. But yeah, happy enough. So let's just continue with the fishing. Which it was shaking with the wind. this wood. There's a little codling. He's a little fish. I was struggling to bring this in. I couldn't figure out why. And I've actually caught my other trace that I lost about 20 minutes ago. Sort out an almighty mess of traces. Jesus. So there's a codling and a flounder on different traces. Doesn't happen every day. Spotted, but still a flounder. Yeah, still a flounder. Smaller around here. Oh, there's one. And there's another little one. Three fish in less than 2 minutes. Good stuff. That's the way you do it. Just fish a little bigger. Doesn't seem to be catching much else. This time, and at the moment, your guess is as good as mine. I would say some kind of blenny, I think. It looks like it. I have to check it out. I think it'll be a blenny, though. That's three species today. They're doing well. Another jewel. Flounder. Nice little flounder. And another wood codlin. So, that's not bad. Getting a bit dark. I hope you can see this okay. Don't have my lights with me. So, first of all, got another half hour and then give up. But I've done so, done good today though. A lot better than I thought. So, I'm happy. Right, that's it. It's just after 7 o'clock. Still about an hour at least till high tide, but I don't have lights and it's kind of hard to see things around here. The street lights are not worth bothering about. So give it up. Had about 15 flounders, I think. Maybe more, I'll check. A couple of codlin and a blenny. So all in all, it's been a decent session. After my past few that I've had to go, I think this has been good. So hope you enjoy watching this, and see you about when I get to make the next one. Try and get away from the cave.